You're being overtaken by green invaders. No, not aliens from outer space. I'm talking about plants from other states and even other countries. You've probably heard of invasive species of animals that arrive here and impact the local environment. But have you ever heard of invasive plants? Well, I invited Dr. Emily Rauscher over to explain. She's an assistant professor of plant ecology at Cleveland State University. I started by asking her, what is an invasive plant?
An invasive plant has to have two important qualities. One is that it's not from here, so it's not from Ohio or it's not from North America. But there are a lot of plants like that that we really value, like a lot of our crops are also not originally from Ohio. So to be considered an invasive, it also has to be causing harm in some way. So it might impact human health in a negative way. It might lower the diversity of other plants because it competes with plants. It could also cause economic damage, so we have to pay a lot of money to get rid of it or to fix problems that it creates. And sometimes they change the way ecosystems work as well.
So tell me a little bit about some of the invasive species that you brought in for us to see today. What's this first one in the front with these pretty berries?
So this first one in the front with the berries is bush honeysuckle, which is an invasive shrub. And unfortunately, once you have it, it gets spread by birds who love to come and eat the little red berries. So it's difficult to get rid of it once you have a lot of it because the birds will keep spreading it. Another plant that I brought, this is the common reed, which is also called Phragmites. And this one is of a special concern because it can grow so densely that no native plants can grow with it. And it can take over large wet areas and really just become the only plant you see there, which can be harmful for the wildlife as well. And so there's a lot of big projects to try and get rid of some of it so that native plants can come back.
And another one, this one on the end, I recognize this when I saw it. It's your simple English ivy. I didn't realize this was an invasive species. I see this in everyone's yard.
This is a really common species for people to plant for ground cover. And unfortunately, if it just stayed in your yard, it wouldn't be so bad, but it can spread into forests a little bit. And then native plants have a hard time growing through because there's so much ivy growing very densely. And so English ivy is one of the plants that is also not native, and it's causing trouble for some native species.
So some of that harm that we've talked about with these is it makes a lot of competition for other plants.
That's right.
And that it can be really hard to get rid of. And you said that there's another one that, thank you for not bringing it in. What is it called?
Giant hogweed, yes.
And what does giant hogweed do? It's an invasive plant.
So giant hogweed is a phototoxic plant, meaning it has toxic effects in the light. So if you get the sap on your skin and then you're in the sun just a little bit, you can get a really bad burn from the sun. So that's one of the ones I didn't want to bring because I don't want any of us to have that problem. But it is a human health impact species, so we work very hard to get rid of it when we see it.
Right, that's like a reverse sunscreen.
That's exactly right. It's just like reverse sunscreen.
And so what can we do to kind of stop invasive plants from growing?
So the first thing is to not plant invasive plants if you can avoid it. There's a lot of great native nurseries. And that's the best way is to not have them here in the first place. If you already have them, maybe in your yard and you want to get rid of them, you could try pulling them out or digging them out. We call that mechanical control. That works if there's a little bit, but sometimes that's a lot of effort. And so you can use herbicides to get rid of some invasive plants. And that works better if it's a bigger area that has a problem. We also sometimes have biological control where scientists have found insects or sometimes it's a fungus that will hopefully attack just the invasive plant and nothing else as a way to deal with a problem that's on a larger scale. But you have to be careful with biological control that it really just impacts the invasive and it doesn't hurt any of our native plants or our crop plants.
So first step is just don't plant any English ivy in my garden.
That's right. And if you have some in your garden, you might want to think long term and slowly remove some of it. And there are a lot of native alternatives that you could plant in your yard instead of invasives.
Great. Well, thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you. Thanks for inviting me.
Have you ever seen any of the invasive plants Dr. Emily brought over in your backyard? Let us know in the comment section below.